स्टूडेंट आई एम विजय सर टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू टीच यू सोशल साइंस सब स्टैंडर्ड 5 टुडे हियर वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट लेसन नंबर 16 टुडेस टॉपिक इज फ्रीडम स्ट्रगल ओके इन प्रीवियस क्लासेस वी हैव स्टडीड अबाउट यू नो फ्रीडम स्ट्रगल टुवर्ड्स आवर कंट्री एंड नाउ इन दिस In that chapter, we have studied in previous classes that how, you know, first time Portuguese or European came in this country and Battle of Plassey was fought and the first war of independence took place. Understand? So, here in this country, in our country, you know, India ruled about 200 years. Understand? So, just after that, just I am telling you about that, okay? So in this lesson we will just talk about the freedom struggle and we will also study about the nationalism and multiracial, multilingual, okay, and the, about the rise of the nationalism, understand, and foundation of Indian National Congress, and after that about the Swadeshi movement. So dear students, as we know that our country is a vast country, it is a vast country where we live in this country, so here there are varieties of people, those who follow different types of religion, and we speak different type of languages. Okay, so India is a vast country with a multiracial, multilingual, and multilingual. Okay, and multireligious also. So at first we will know about that. Multiracial means many races. Multilingual means using several languages. In this country, people, they, you know, speak different types of languages, okay? There are, you know, 28 states. In that particular state, the people of the state, they speak different types of languages. If we will take the example of, you know, Tamil Nadu, the people of Tamil Nadu, they speak Tamil. The people of Kerala, they speak, you know, Malayalam. So, in most part of the countries, people, they speak Hindi. So Hindi is mother tongue, understand? So here in this country, people also, they follow different types of religions. Understand? That's why I said that people follow, you know, different types of religion, that is known as the multi-religions. Understand? So now, after that, just we will discuss about that, you know, nationalism. It means that a patriotic feeling. Nationalism means patriotic feeling or feeling towards independence. Means a feeling of national independence. Understand? So, Indian people, they struggled hard that after that we got the independence. Okay. Now we will talk about the rise of the nationalism. Understand? So, after 1857, means after the first war of independence, people, you know, many Indian people, they took active part in this movement, or just, you know, they started thinking or acting. So many social reformers came, like Ishwar Chandra Vidyasagar, Annie Besant, you know, Kesava Chandra Sen. So these people were the social reformers who eradicate, means who try to solve the problems of Sati Pratha and caste system and child marriage. So this, you know, these were the social ethics of that time. Okay, that's why they just solved all the problems. Understand? So after that, what happened? Just I'm telling you. So many, you know, Indians started thinking or acting, and they took active part, and they also just tried to solve all the problems. So in our society, there were some problems. There was caste system, you know, and Sati Pratha. So these systems were eradicated by the people, some social reformers. Okay, so it was solved by the social reformer. So after that, what happened? You know, A.O. Hume, understand, A.O. Hume in 1885, he took 100 of educated people and he founded first time Indian National Congress. So his name was A.O. Hume. He only founded the Indian National Congress in 1885. His name was Alan Octavian Hume. Okay, A.O. Hume. He was a civil servant. He took 100 of educated persons and after that he founded the Indian National Congress. So in this, what happened? People knew about it and the Indian National Congress became very popular. It spread all over the country. Then many moderate and extremist leaders came forward. The leaders who were moderates, they were just, you know, they believed in the method of peace and calm and persuasion. And those who were extremists, they were against the moderate. They thought in the method of, they believed that with a strong action can be taken. So they started, you know, doing war or fights with the British because they needed independence. Understand? So that's why I said to you that, so Bal Gangadhar Tilak and other leaders also, Bhagat Singh, Subhash Chandra Bose, they were the extremists. They were against the moderate. And this, then after that Bal Gangadhar Tilak, he said that, no, freedom is my birthright and I will have it. Who said?
Bal Gangadhar Tilak said.
And he also, sometimes he used to write in his magazine, Kesari. Okay, understand? So, that's why I am telling that extremists, those who were extremists, they were against the moderate leaders. Okay, that's why they also took active part in this movement and they began to fight with the British. Then after that, in 1905, British then planned to divide the Bengal into two parts. Understand? And East Bengal for the Muslims and the West Bengal for the Hindus. So it was declared in 1905. So after that, the partition of Bengal was announced. Okay. So just I am saying you that about that. Now we will talk about the Swadeshi movement. So in this movement, what happened? The protests against the partition were combined by the boycott of British goods. Means that time, you know, people of this country were using the goods of those who were, you know, British were making the goods in the England, or, you know, British, they forced the Indians or forced the farmers to grow indigo, and they were taking that dye, you know, blue color dye, and they were just dyeing their clothes in Europe or England, or they were bringing the clothes from the Europe and they were selling into the India markets at the lower price. So people, they buy products, they say that we will not use, you know, British goods. That's why what happened. So the students of Bengal, you know, took active part in this movement. So in that time what happened, you know, British clothes were burned in heat. Okay, British clothes were burned in heat. And many students, they took part. They said, no, we will not use the British clothes. So this movement was known as the Swadeshi movement. Okay, they said that we will use only Indian goods. We will use only Indian goods. So after that, many liberalists came, okay, many liberalists. So they also, by God, they did not use the clothes of the British. Okay, so they were also wanted to fight with the British. Then after that, we got the independence. So when there are so many examples of, you know, freedom fighters like Khudiram Bose, Chandrasekhar Azad, they fought many battles and they also struggled hard with the British. Understand? So after that, we got the independence. So just I am saying that, so this people were, that Khudiram Bose and Chandrasekhar Azad were, you know, rigorous. Okay. So two young persons, Prafulla Chakki and Khudiram Bose, fired at a British officer. Khudiram Bose, he was only 15 years old, was arrested and hanged. He was also hanged by the British. Okay. So we have many examples of rebellious, those who have fought with the British, then they struggled hard, then after that we got the independence. Some people started working for, you know, from other countries for the freedom of India. Many people, that this, I am giving you some more examples, like, you know, Madame Kama. Madame Kama also went to Geneva and published a newspaper. She went to Geneva and she published a newspaper called Bande Mataram. So she was also working for the Indian people. She also wanted freedom. So she also, you know, she also wanted to free country from the British control. Understand? So the people from the Punjab also had settled in America, formed the Gadar Party. Okay. So they also started thinking something, or they also wanted to free this country from the British control. Understand? So just I am telling you that after that World War I broke out in 1940. So many Indians helped the government in the war. They thought that the British would feel, you know, obliged and grant freedom to India. Okay, so but this did not happen. The government made strict laws and enforced them very harshly. Okay, so in 1915, when Mohandas Karamchand Gandhi, he returned from the Africa, South Africa, okay, after the training of lawyer, so he also led, or he also struggled for the country, or he also means took part in many, you know, struggles or many movements. Then after that we got the independence. Okay, so when he came India, he helped many people, many Indians. Understand? And he also started satyagraha movements and salt movements. So that topic we will learn about in the next lesson. Okay. So dear students, I hope you understood about this all the topics. Just you go through the chapter, read nicely. So till then, thank you, have a nice day. We will meet in the next video with the next story. So bye.